we fall out. That's how we fall out. That's how we fall out. That's how we fall out. Blow it up, blow it up. That's how we fall out. That's how we fall out. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you're new. My name's Ajwa and today's video is a makeup tutorial. I know I haven't done these in a long time and I'm so sorry. I just haven't been feeling makeup like that anymore, but I think I'm back. Good news, the tutorials where I talk about serial killers are gonna be back soon, so please wait on those. Yeah, so today I decided to show you guys my soft glam slash everyday makeup look. Usually it'll take me about like half an hour to an hour to do, depending on how intricate I do my eyes and all of that. So if you want to see how I did this look, keep watching. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and when you subscribe, don't forget to hit that notification bell so you get notified for every single video that I put up. And without further ado, let's get on with the video. Hey y'all, so it's been a hot minute since I've done a makeup tutorial. To be completely honest, I haven't really been into makeup. I literally go to school with just like concealer and my brows and like mascara on because like, first of all, I don't have time. So yeah, but I honestly find that when I have my full like soft glam beat, I'm really feeling myself, and I've been looking at it and it actually looks pretty seamless, so I figured I would show you guys my look. I've been wearing it in most of my sit down videos, so if you wanted to see how I created that look, this is the video for you. So let's get on with it. Let me zoom you guys in first so we can get to the good stuff. We're all up close and personal today. Please don't mind my nails. I've been doing a lot of cleaning and stuff, so I painted them and they just got really bad. But to prime my face, I'm using the Milk Hydro Grip Primer. I honestly love this primer. I've been using it for quite some time and I just love the texture of it. So many YouTubers, like beauty YouTubers, were talking about it. I didn't think it was that amazing, but I like the finish that it gives my makeup, and I like that it's sticky. And if I'm looking down, it's because of my mirror. Honestly, I kind of miss making tutorials. It's just lost that creative bug that I had where I could like come up with looks like that. Like if you guys follow me on Instagram, my Instagram took a whole different turn. Like I have a makeup Instagram that I think it's private, but I used to post like my makeup looks on my main one because I had the most followers there and I thought I'd reach more people. But yeah, I'm not as creative when it comes to makeup. Like I can't come up with like, you know, looks anymore, which is really sad, but I feel like with practice I could get it back again. I'm just gonna wait like a minute or two for the primer to set. How have you guys been doing? Like, I know I've been posting, like I've been posting more fitness stuff because your girl has become so into fitness. It's actually crazy. I have fitness related plans that I want to accomplish soon. So hopefully that will happen. For foundation, I actually got my right shade now. I'm going in with the Too Faced Born This Way foundation. And I'm in the shade Sable. The shade that I got earlier, like last year or 2 years ago, is way, way too light for me. This might look dark, but it works. Especially when I put everything else. And I honestly love the finish of this foundation. So I'm gonna go in with my Beauty Blender first. Because I don't really like a full coverage look. The undertone might be a little off, but trust me, like, in daylight, when everything's all blended, it looks like my skin. My arms hurt. I've been playing Just Dance as a form of exercise because the gym is closed down. I want to see my play tonight. Oh, this looks so bad on camera. Wow, usually it doesn't look this bad, trust me. It all comes together, I swear. And then I'm gonna go in with my Morphe M439 brush. I'm clearly not like a YouTube, beauty guru type person anymore. I used to know my brushes. And like, I haven't even been buying that much makeup. I've been focusing more on skincare. And my skin is looking so nice right now. Oh, it's the best. So to conceal my face, I use the Born This Way, what is this called? Multi-use sculpting concealer. And I believe this is in the shade Cocoa. It's a good amount on there. Because I look like I haven't slept. And I went to bed at like 2 in the morning. So. And literally, I don't really highlight anywhere else. Like sometimes if I'm really feeling it, I'll like do a little bit, like right here. And that's it. Like, I don't highlight my nose, my chin. I know that's not like standard, but that's just how I like to do my makeup. Like, I didn't really like highlighting. I just did it because like that's what everyone else did, so. And sometimes if I'm really feeling it, like I will go in with a cream contour. The cream contour I like to use is this Sephora Bright Future Gel Serum Concealer. It's in the shade Hot Cocoa. I don't think it looks like this, especially the applicator anymore. They changed the applicator. But I still have concealer, so I'm not gonna waste it. My beauty blender to blend out my concealer. I like to let it sit for a little bit because it gives me better coverage that way. It's a trick I learned from Miss Jackie Einer herself. The under eyes are done. I'm gonna go in with my OG Laura Mercier translucent powder. I alternate between like this regular translucent and the medium deep depending on the look that I want to go for that day. If I want to look like super duper snatched, I'll go for the regular. And like I kind of bake but kind of don't. A majority of the powder actually like sinks into your skin. Like look at the difference. I know it seems like a lot of powder, trust me. But it works. And I kind of like blend it into my eye. The outer corner. It's like I've forgotten all like makeup terminology. This is crazy. Like my under eyes look so good. And then just before I'm able to like powder contour, I take a little bit of the translucent powder and just dust it on my face. Not too much, because you know, I don't want to be looking casket ready. And then before we get into the rest of the face, I'm actually going to be putting some powder on my brows to soak up any oils. Honestly, I feel like the color comes out like so much better this way. I know I'm looking crazy. Trust me, it's gonna come together. Ooh, I am looking real crazy. So to contour my face, I'm gonna be using It's My Ray Ray collaboration with BH Cosmetics, and I'm gonna be using this dark shade right here. It's a shame they don't have this anymore. Like, once I run out of this, I don't really know what I'm gonna use. And then I'm gonna be using this BH Studio Pro number 3 brush to contour my face in this like light feathering motions. Yes, I use blush. I honestly love how it looks. It makes me look so cute and stuff, you know. So I've been using this e.l.f. blush palette in dark, and I'm going to be using the shade right here and just like put it where you're supposed to put it, like this. Like, you can kind of see it. And then I learned this trick from, I think Arnell, she does this, and she like puts it on her nose. Honestly, it looks so cute. Like, it's not that noticeable, but it's so cute. Like, you look flushed and, I don't know. I like how it looks. So we're done that. I'm not gonna do highlighter right now. We're actually gonna move into the eyes, my eyebrows. I'm gonna do my brows off camera, and then I'll be right back so we can go and do the eye makeup. This is so difficult for me for some weird reason. I'm gonna go into this Makeup Geek shadow for my transition shade. It's in the shade Cocoa Bear. I know Makeup Geek recently did a like rebranding, and they changed the name of it. I don't really know what the new name is. I'll try to find it out. And I'm taking this E23 brush, and I'm just putting this right above the crease, like closer to the brow bone area. I can be messy with this because it's a transition shade. Everything is gonna blend into it. And for my first crease color, I'm gonna use this contour kit. I Feel Focus. It's Contour Kit Refill. It's in the shade Carob from ABH. I don't even know if they make these anymore. I'll try to link everything down below. Let's put this in the crease, like right in the crease. Like all, like from the end of like the outer corner all the way to the inner corner. Honestly, this is like the perfect brown, one of the perfect browns for a soft glam look. It's a soft makeup look. You can literally just put this in your crease every day. Put on some eyeliner or just put this all over your eye and you'll be good. And I'm using a E28 brush from Morphe. For my second crease color, I'm using the infamous ABH Jackiana collab, and I'm gonna go into the shade Credit, which is this perfect brown for us brown girls. It's right here. I'm gonna put this and focus this mainly on the outer portion of my eye, like in the outer V. It like creates this perfect like smoky effect. Take this M330 brush and just blend everything out because you don't want harsh lines in your look. You want it to look seamless. And for your lid shade, we're gonna go into this ABH eyeshadow in the shade Chocolate. It's this like chocolate brown, but it's metallic. This is what it looks like on your finger. It looks really, really beautiful. So I'm just gonna use my finger and just put this on my lid. It's really subtle and that's why I love it so much. And it's so smooth, buttery. It's just amazing. And it doesn't really matter if it gets on your like your creases, because it looks good either way. And then sometimes if I'm really feeling it, I will go back in with Credit just to like clean everything up. I know it doesn't really look like much because of the lights, but trust me, it's a look. And then I'm going to line my eyes with this NYX Epic Ink Liner in the shade Black. With the way my camera is set up, I can't really show you, so I'm just gonna do the eyeliner off camera. This is the first one. It's not like super dramatic or anything, just simple. Eyeliner is done, lashes are on. We're getting to the end of the makeup look. I like to spice this look up a little bit by doing a little bit of inner corner highlight and a little bit of brow bone highlight. Where's my little brush? I use this little e.l.f. small smudge brush. And I'm gonna go into the shade Lituation from the Jackiana palette. I'm just gonna put this right here. It's subtle, that's why I love it. So to highlight my face, I'm gonna use the OG ABH Sun Dip Glow Kit, and I'm gonna take this E61 brush, and I'm gonna go into tourmaline. I used to use bronze, but I'm more of a tourmaline girl right now. I take that same small e.l.f. brush and I go into tourmaline, make a little dot right here, and then like blend it out with my finger, and then go down the bridge of my nose a little bit. I'm gonna use this M326 brush, and gonna go into bronze, dab off the excess, and just put a little bit on my brow bone and blend it out. So for lips, I'm gonna use this Annabelle eyeliner. It's been a struggle to try and find a lip liner that's dark enough, that especially like a dark brown lip liner. So I heard this trick from a girl I follow on Instagram, and she uses eyeliner pencils to line her lips, and honestly it's a life changer. So if you're a dark skin girl like me and you're struggling to find a dark brown lip liner, check out some eyeliners, and they are honestly so smooth and buttery you won't know the difference. So I just dabbed off a little bit of my chapstick and I'm gonna line my lips. I kind of overline the top a little bit, and then I fill in the sides here, not by much, and then I go in with Fenty's hot chocolate. I still have the minis. I know they came out with the full size and I was so happy when they did that. I just put that. It low-key reminds me of the 90s, you know, when they used to use like super, super dark lip liner and then like lip gloss. Yeah. Okay, so this is a finished look, you guys. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did enjoy the video, please give me a big thumbs up. That lets me know that you guys want more tutorials, and leave some comments down below letting me know your thoughts on this look. Don't forget to subscribe. We are so close to 450 subscribers. Honestly, I can't wait to hit that, because if I hit 1,000 subscribers, I'm gonna do a huge giveaway. So yeah, I hope you all enjoyed. I think I said that already, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.